Hello everyone. Today we will study about coal and petroleum. This is chapter number 5 from NCERT book of class 8. In this chapter, we shall study about various natural resources. Natural resources are the resources which are provided by the nature to us, and these resources are very important for the maintenance of our life. For our basic needs, we depend on natural resources. Resources into two main categories depending on their availability in nature. And the first category is inexhaustible natural resources. These are the resources which are present in unlimited quantity. That means they are present in huge amount and they are not likely to be exhausted. They will not get finished by the human use. Example of such kind of natural resources are air, sunlight and water. Category is exhaustible natural resources. These resources are present in limited quantity. They may get exhausted, they may get finished by the overuse. And the example of this kind of resources are all fossil fuel, that is coal, petroleum, natural gas. And beside this, forest and wildlife and even the minerals are exhaustible natural resources. So first of all, we shall study about coal. Coal is a fossil fuel and it is a hard substance. It is as hard as a stone. It is black in color. Regarding the uses of coal, it is used for cooking purpose. It is used to run the railway engine. And it is used in thermal power plants. How it is used in thermal power plants actually? It is used to boil water and that will produce a steam. That steam is used for rotating the turbines and finally electricity is produced. And beside this, coal is also used as fuel in various industries. How coal was formed? About 300 million years ago, the forest got buried under the soil because of flood. And as more soil deposited over them, they were compressed. And inside the soil, because there was high temperature and high pressure, the dead plants slowly got converted into coal. The slow process of conversion of dead vegetation, that means the dead plants, into the coal is called carbonization. Why do we call carbonization? Because carbon mainly present in the coal. Coal mainly contains carbon, right? This is the reason we call this process as carbonization. And because it is formed from the dead remains of the plants, from the dead remains of the vegetation, so it is a fossil fuel. Regarding the properties of coal, when it is burnt in air, when it is heated in air, it burns to produce carbon dioxide gas. And coal is processed in the industries to get some other useful products like the coke, coal gas and the coal tar. These three are the important products which we get from coal. And we shall study them. First one is the coke. Coke is a tough, that is it is hard, porous and black substance. It is the pure form of carbon. Regarding the uses of coke, it is used in extraction of many metals. It is used as a reducing agent for extraction of metals. And the second use is it is used for manufacturing of steel. Second product which we get from coal is coal tar. Coal tar is a black, thick liquid and it is very foul smelling. It is having very unpleasant smell. It is a mixture of about 200 substances. The products which we get from coal tar, then they are used for making some other materials which are used in our daily life. Coal tar, it is used for making the synthetic dyes, that is the synthetic colors, for making the drugs, explosives, perfume. Yes, this is surprising, isn't it? Perfume is such a good smelling substance and it is obtained from a foul smelling substance, that is coal tar. Kolzar is also used for making plastic, paints, photographic materials, and the roofing materials. You must have heard about naphthalene balls. These are used to keep the moth and insects away from the clothes. These are kept in the clothes and in the almira to repel the insects. This is also obtained from kolzar. Earlier, kolzar was used for road surfacing also, but nowadays a petroleum product, that is bitumen, is used for this purpose. Next important product of coal is coal gas. Coal gas is obtained during the processing of coal to get coke. When there is a conversion of coal into coke, then coal gas is produced and it is used as fuel in many industries. Coal gas is used in the industries which are lying in the nearby plants where coal is being converted into coke. And coal tar is used for surfacing of the road. Earlier it was used for this purpose, but nowadays in the developed areas, developed countries, bitumen is used for this purpose. Initially coal gas was used for street lighting, but nowadays it is used as a source of heat and energy only, not as. Next important fossil fuel is petroleum. Petroleum was formed from the organisms which were living in the sea, and as these organisms died, they got settled at the bottom of the sea, then they got discovered with the sand and clay, and after millions of years, because of absence of air, high temperature and high pressure, these organisms got transformed into petroleum and natural gas. From this diagram, you can have an idea that oil and gas, this petroleum, oil means petroleum here, this petroleum and the gas are found above water because they are lighter than water. Okay, so from here you can have an idea. This is an important point which we should memorize. The first oil well was drilled in Pennsylvania. It is a place in USA. It was done in the year 1859. And in India, this petroleum is found in Assam, Gujarat, Mumbai High, and the river basins of Krishna and Godavari rivers. Petroleum is a very dark and foul smelling substance. It is a mixture of various constituents like the petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. All these things are separated from the petroleum, and this process of separation is called refining. It is done in the refineries called petroleum refinery. During the refining of the petroleum, many useful substances are obtained, and these substances are called petrochemicals. So petrochemicals are the substances which are obtained from the petroleum, and these are of petroleum origin, no doubt. Various petrochemicals are used for manufacturing of detergents, synthetic fibers like nylon, polyester, acrylic, etc. It is used for making polythene and plastic. Hydrogen is also obtained from the natural gas, and then it is used for making fertilizer, especially the urea. Because this petroleum is having great commercial use, great commercial importance, so many useful substances are obtained from petroleum. This is the reason we call it black gold. It is black in color and it is very important, so it is called black gold. This is a list showing various constituents of petroleum and then their uses. First one is LPG, that is liquefied petroleum gas. It is used as industrial and domestic fuel. Petroleum used as motor fuel, aviation fuel, and it is used for dry cleaning also. Kerosene used as fuel in the stove and the lamp. It is also used as a fuel in jet aircraft. Diesel used as heavy motor vehicle fuel, and it is used in electric power generators. Lubricating oil, as the name suggests, its function will be lubrication. Paraffin wax is used for making ointments, candles and vaseline. Bitumen, as we have done, it is used for road surfacing, and it is also used in making paints. Now the natural gas. Natural gas is again, it is a very important fossil fuel. It is found above the oil in the region from where the petroleum is extracted, and it is stored under high pressure and then it is compressed. So we call it CNG, compressed natural gas. And CNG is used for power generation and it is also used as a fuel in the vehicles. It is a clean fuel. That is, it is less polluting and it is having high calorific value. It can be used directly for burning in the homes. For burning means here as a fuel. It is used in home and factories and it is supplied through the natural gas is also used as starting material for getting some other useful substances, some other useful chemicals which are used for making fertilizers. As we have discussed, one such chemical is hydrogen. Then in India, natural gas is found in Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and the deltas of Krishna and Godavari rivers. As we have discussed that petroleum is a fossil fuel and it is an exhaustible natural resource. So we should use it wisely. PCRA, in India, PCRA, Petroleum Conservation Research Association, advise people how to save petrol or diesel while driving. There are some recommendations by PCRA and these are as follows. One is we should drive at a constant speed and the moderate speed. As far as possible, I know it is not possible all the time, but as far as possible, it should be constant and moderate. Then we should switch off the engine at the traffic light and when we are waiting for someone in the vehicle, inside the vehicle, then we should switch off the engine and ensure that there should be correct tire pressure in the vehicle. That also saves a lot of fuel. Another important recommendation is that there should be regular maintenance of the vehicle. And if there will be regular maintenance of the engine, in that case, it will work with efficiency and it will cause less pollution. It will consume less fuel. So these are some recommendations by PCRA. With this, we have completed the chapter. Thank you so much. Thank you.